late here, but was it a tough sell, easy sell? Can you come back?
No, not really. It probably was tough because I enjoyed my years at South Carolina, but it was easy in the way that, you know, this is a place that I played, and it's a part of who I am. And, you know, this is also the place that I came back to when I cut my teeth as a graduate assistant coach. So, you know, Tennessee was always a place that I saw myself coaching. So,
it's a pretty productive years here as a running back. When you look at what Tennessee's been able to accomplish or maybe not accomplish in the running game past couple of years, what do you see? What kind of imprint do you want to put on the program, at least immediately?
The thing that I always try to do is just teach guys how to run hard, you know, and play the game at that running back position the right way, to do all the things to help your offense be successful. You know, I've had the opportunity to meet these young men. So, you know, as we go through, I'll continue to evaluate them. But that's the thing that we were always going to talk about, the things that are important for, you know, running backs to do to make this team successful.
Jay, what do you think you've been able to have a pretty good track record of recruiting in just a short time kind of in South Carolina?
I think a lot of the backs that I've recruited, they can identify with me. I've played in the NFL. I played in this conference. So, you know, I think a lot of those guys can identify with that.
It was like coaching with Coach Spurrier, and what'd you learn from him?
A lot of things. Just learned about protections, and you know, he's really good offensively. So, you know, I learned his offense, which was really good. Was a new offense to learn. So it's always good as a coach when you go to a place to, you know, kind of grow offensively, and you know, I did that.
Outside the X's and O's, just attitude, approach, just anything that you picked up down there that you'll bring here?
Say that again.
Outside of the X's and O's, what did you learn from him?
You know, every coach does something different. So, you know, he has a way of doing recruiting, and, you know, I learned that way. Just learned professionalism, how to be professional, all those different things that you have to do on a campus. You know, those are the things that I've learned.
Jay, although you said you wanted to coach at Tennessee at some point, you're not just leaving a more successful program in terms of a career move. You're leaving a running back who could maybe win the Heisman Trophy. And that looks pretty good on your resume. Did you weigh that at all, the fact that you could have Marcus Lattimore for another year?
I did, and not because he's a Heisman Trophy candidate, but because he's a good young man. And, you know, we talked about it, and I said you probably would go back and coach at your alma mater if you were at the same in the same position. And he agreed, and, you know, it was a good talk, a good conversation, and, you know, he's a good young man, so.
How do you feel like being a former running back benefits, you know, coaching a group that's not had a former running back coaching them the last couple of years?
I think because I walked in their shoes, I've done some of the things that they do, I think they can identify with that and they understand it. Certainly, yeah, you have to know how to coach them, you know, and you know, I think that, you know, kind of validates it. But, you know, I think it's good that you've been in their shoes, you know, and you've played on different levels. And, you know, so when they come off the sideline, you kind of understand a little bit more about how they're feeling as you go through the game or go through practice.
Jay, when you signed with UT, as I recall, they were pretty stacked at running back at the time. So was that something you considered as a negative, that you got all these guys ahead of you? Just go through the process when you made that decision to come to UT.
Just, I wanted to learn from those guys. You know, on an official visit, I got a chance to hang around Aaron Hayden and Charlie Garner, all those guys. And, you know, they told me at the time, they were like, hey, you're not going to play till your junior year. But, you know, and everybody else was telling me I was going to start as a freshman. But, you know, I could understand that. But I like the guys. And, you know, I like learning underneath those guys. So that was what I did for 2 years.
So that did the idea that you might not play extensively till your junior, that wasn't a negative?
Well, I thought I was going to play right away still, but turns out they were right.
you had that kind of surreal moment. I mean, it was 19 years ago, you were at the Steakhouse signing with Tennessee, and now you're sitting here, you know, talking about the running backs of Tennessee as a coach. And you had a moment that was kind of like, just when you reflected on the journey to get here from, you know, signing so many years ago?
Yeah, I've thought about it. You know, when I see Gibbs Hall, you know, I remember walking out of that dorm and coming over to the weight room to work out. You know, that's when I think about it, that, you know, it's funny, you know, I guess 15, 16 years later, I'm getting an opportunity to coach these young men, and I, you know, I walked in their same shoes. So those are the things that I think about.
Have you had to educate guys like Marlon and Tom as to who you are and what you did while you were here, you know, to build that level of respect and that sort of thing? Because I'm sure they don't have to play.
Well, a little bit. We just had a couple of meetings, so, 'cause when I came in, they were already gone for Christmas break. But, you know, one of the guys pointed in the corner of the wall. I guess my picture was up. He was like, is that you? So they're starting to figure out a little bit who I am.
Jay, you talked about having walked in the shoes before. With that experience, I mean, how does that help you on the recruiting trail, or specifically, how does that help you identify what you're looking for in the running back?
Well, as far as recruiting, I'm sitting on a young man's couch. I'm a product of what I'm selling. You know, I think that's important, that his parents can see, you know, that, you know, if you play well, you can have a chance to go into the NFL, and possibly some young men want to go off and coach. So, you know, I can talk about those things. So I think the parents can see, you know, this is what, you know, I would like for my young man to end up doing.
Jay, what makes a good running back in your mind?
Certainly, yeah, you got to have dynamic skill level. I mean, that's important, especially playing in this conference where it's, you know, probably five of the top 25 defense, you know, they're in the top five are going to be from the SEC. And you have to have, you know, a mental toughness and ability to break tackles and do all those things. And you have to have that ability. I'll always look for a young man who can adapt, you know, because when you get to college, you're going to have to adapt to this level of play. And you always look for young men who are mentally tough that can do that.
Jay, when you started out as a running back in the same league, it was pretty good then too. What was the toughest thing you had to adjust to in the SEC? What did you, if anything, struggle with early on?
You said as a player?
As a player, yeah.
Just the speed of the game. Those guys, and it's a lot faster than it used to be. They used to line up in base defense and just play it. But probably the speed of the defensive linemen, you know, those things. Linebackers, they're a lot faster. And, you know, when you're in high school, you're the best player, you know, on that field or really in the state. But when you get on that field in the SEC, it's top players in the country out there.
Jay, how much will you talk to the current players about the pride, about wearing the T, and what it means to represent the University of Tennessee?
A lot. You know, I think that's important for, you know, our young men to understand that and know what it means and understand the tradition and the storied history here. So, you know, I'll talk a lot about that.
Jay, how much have you watched those guys on tape and evaluated them to get an assessment, or is your approach to clean slate and get the spring ball with them? How do you approach that?
Really, I'm really trying to watch plays to see what we do. Not necessarily to evaluate them as much, because I think you evaluate on the field in person. I think that's the best way to do it instead of just on tape. And a lot of it is trying to see what they were thinking, what they were coached to do. All those things go into, you know, figuring out how we can tweak this or what we have to do as far as going forward.
How much does it help that not only you're familiar with the university, but you've recruited North Carolina for a few years and you're from there? How much does that make this kind of transition seamless, that you can still recruit there, it's a few hours away and you're from there and you're so familiar with everything?
It's really good. You know, it's good when you move as a coach that you can keep those same recruiting areas. So that's always a good thing.
Excuse me, when you were recruiting, I assume you were in on the recruiting of Marcus Lattimore.
Mm-hmm.
So when you saw him in person or on video, did he just jump out at you as the kind of guy you think of as a can't-miss guy? What did you see in him when you first looked at him?
When I saw him on video, I said I thought he was a really good running back, real good. But I met him in person and started talking to him. The more I started talking to him, the more I realized what type of young man he is and how hard he works. You know, that's key. How tough he is, all those things. And then I had a chance to meet his family. And that's when you know the kid's going to be something special.
Is he the kind of guy you might use as an example now when you're recruiting other running backs or even to the guys that are already on the roster here?
Sure. You know, he's always an example you can look at. When I talk to young men about, hey, you got to study your film, you got to do all those different things to prepare yourself to play in a game, he does a lot of that.
What's your coaching style? I mean, are you real demonstrative on the practice field in the games or more reserved?
It depends on the player and it depends on what he does.
Anything else, guys?
Can you give us an idea of what you see when you watch the film of Dalton Hill? The guy just showed up a couple days ago. I know you weren't part of the process to get him here, but I'm sure they've shown you some tape on him, that sort of thing.
He has a lot of speed, and I didn't know how big he would be, you know, until I met him. And when I saw him, he's big. Just to have that type of speed, and he can change direction. He has good hips and explosion. So, you know, we'll see once we put him in pads.
Thanks, guys, very much. Thanks, Jay.